Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. We're living in a world where things are becoming very expensive. Many people cannot afford a lot of things. How do we deal with this difficulty? The sustainer is Allah. He provides. Number one, turn to Allah. Make sure your connection with Allah is correct to the best of your ability. Call out to Allah, supplicate to Him, and pray as you are meant to pray, and even more. So when you turn to Allah, doors of sustenance begin to open. Seek lots of forgiveness from Allah Almighty. He will help you in your sustenance. He will sustain you and provide for you. Nuh alayhi salam called his people. One of the things he said is, when you seek the forgiveness of Allah sincerely, He will open the doors of wealth for you as well. Then make sure you haven't harmed someone else. When we harm others, the curse of the evil deed may come to us and affect the blessings in our lives. So even if we have some wealth, there will be sickness, disease, unruliness, so much of stress and anxiety, lack of sleep and so on, because we've harmed another human being. Either we said something about them, we belittled them, abused them, maybe even stolen from them. In some cases, people have shortchanged others and they've laughed at how intelligent they were and how silly the other people were, not realizing Allah is watching. So you lose out on the broader benefits of your sustenance because you wronged someone. So number one, you connect with Allah. Number two, make sure you didn't wrong someone. Seek forgiveness from the people. Humble yourself. Number three, make sure you try hard every avenue there is to earn or to get a job or to earn some form of money through a business deal, whatever it is, be vigilant and keep trying without giving up. So when you keep trying without giving up, the doors open, because sometimes there will be closed doors, but one door is going to open. You've knocked on 50, 60 doors. Maybe the 61st door is the one that will fling open so wide that you'll be smiling all the way. Then you need to learn to adjust your expenditure to exactly what your standing is. Don't borrow money in order to live a life of luxury. That's the biggest mistake you would make. The Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, allowed us to lend and borrow, but he did not allow us to do that for extravagance, something that's not necessary at all. If it's needed, alhamdulillah, it's a good thing. But to pay back is not going to be so easy. And to get it for that which is futile is never filled with blessings. It's void of blessings. So another very interesting factor is, if Allah's blessed you with a spouse or family members or children, make sure you invest in them, inculcating how important it is to connect with Allah. When you have children and you've never taught them about Allah, you haven't taught them about the Quran, you haven't taught them about some of the rules and regulations of simple cleanliness and simple, you know, duties unto Allah as a Muslim, how do you expect sustenance from the owner of sustenance or blessings in the sustenance from the owner of sustenance? So in order to achieve that, we must make sure we invest in this. Recite the Quran and encourage your family members to recite the Quran. Engage in adhkar and the dua, the supplications, where the Prophet, peace be upon him, asked for the alleviation from poverty. And he's asked to make us independent in such a way that we depend only on Allah. So this is something we need to take into consideration. Many people complain about, how is it that I'm going to sustain myself? How is it in this world that is becoming very expensive? Well, here you are. Allah's helped you to deal with this difficulty by teaching you so many things. This issue of adjusting your life is very important, because today we watch others living on Instagram, on social media, perhaps sometimes in real life terms, those who have more than us. Sometimes people have motor vehicles that are flashy, and yet they are taken on a bank loan, which means the car doesn't belong to them, the house doesn't belong to them. And here we are comparing ourselves with those people who are flashing something that they do not wholly own. How is that? So therefore, be happy with what Allah has given you. That is a favor of Allah, that He favors those who connect with Him, those whom we mentioned the qualities of earlier. So remember, if you are going to connect with Allah and if you are going to be content with what Allah has given you, and you are going to be from among those who thanks Allah for what He's bestowed upon you, then definitely you will be from among those who achieves. You will be from among those who are absolutely happy at all times. When you adjust your life and when you begin to live a life based on what Allah has given you, then you begin to taste a sweetness that is beyond imagination. It's okay if I can't afford to go on a holiday all the time. It's okay if I can't afford to fly business class, or I can't afford to fly at all. Or it's okay, for example, if I can't afford a car and I need to go in public transport. No problem, let me go. Don't be embarrassed and don't be too proud to downgrade your life. At times, even after, there was a time when you might have been able to afford it and then you didn't. So don't be a person who, is too afraid, or like I said, proud of adjusting downwards or downgrading. May Allah Almighty grant us from His goodness. So my brothers and sisters, many times sins actually come in the way of the blessings. They snatch away the blessings. A person is sinning, there's no more blessings in his wealth because he needs to spend on something that is displeasing to Allah, something that is he's not supposed to spend on. It's not his responsibility to spend on. He needs to spend on those things, or he feels he needs to spend on those things. And guess what? He's left with nothing. So this is why we say, if you have wealth that's suddenly depleting, it's like there's a hole in your sack. It probably would be that you're engaged in doing something you're not supposed to be doing. And that's where the money is going. Now, why do we say this? Allah has written the sustenance of yourself, your spouse, and everyone else. You are now putting it into a place that Allah did not ask you to put it into. So it's going out of the coffers. It's going out of the general kitty that you're supposed to be having. And Allah Almighty grant us goodness and a good understanding. Remember, if you want to live in this day and age, you need to save as well. When you save, don't save in a way that inflation keeps eating your wealth. Or zakat might eat it 2.5% every year. And what happens? Your money is just depleting. You need to try and think of ways of saving whereby you have some wealth that is kept, some amount that is kept perhaps for a rainy day. But the bulk of it needs to be reinvested. Go into something, do something. Because Allah's plan is that He wants the wealth to benefit so many others. Usually when you invest money, what happens? You're getting an income, or you're getting part of the profit. There will be people who will be employed. Don't be afraid of employing others, because by you giving them their sustenance that was written by Allah Almighty, you're earning blessings. Imagine your company is feeding 20 families and you're still making a profit. Why not? Don't want to have it all for yourself. The minute you want it all for yourself, you find you become attached to it. When you're attached to it, the blessings are snatched away. They say we keep our wealth in our hands, not in our hearts. So money is here. It's there to be spent. You receive and give the money. It's not in your heart. If it's in your heart, you begin to hate and love because of money. That's a very, very interesting point. So when Allah has blessed you, remain humble. When Allah has given you a lot, be even more humble. Reach out to others, help them, and Allah will grant you ease. I pray that Allah help us to navigate through these difficult times, challenging times. People are struggling with their health, struggling finding jobs, but don't give up. Allah will open your doors, adjust your life, ride the wave for now, go through the difficulty and hardship for a little while. It might prolong a little bit, but the good days are coming by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah bless us all. And may Allah sustain us and our offspring. May Allah give us, and may He be the one whom we rely on and none else. Ameen. Aqulu qawli hadha wa sallallahu wa sallama wa baraka ala nabina Muhammad. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.